But today, one of the things that, throughout this conversation I would bring up is about what makes an entrepreneur, what makes somebody a successful businessman. To me, starts from motivation, determination, hard work, and luck. Now, sometimes people mistaken luck with, and they say, harder I work, luckier I got. But there is a luck factor here. But all of my examples that I will bring to you today, it will be within those parameters that I feel that make one successful. Now, the difference between an entrepreneur and a non-entrepreneur or somebody, to me, is just purely is risk. Somebody is willing to take risk, and somebody do want to take risk.
The one thing that you really always have to do is believe anything is possible. And I think it's great to be here with other people that have the same goal, and to be part of your Small Business Development Center and the Women and Men's Business Center. You want to be around those people that support you, and you know you have a safe place to go to discuss your business. So I'm honored to be here actually representing the Small Business Development Center of Brevard County. They helped me immensely.
We've been known as a small steak and hamburger operation, and I hit on the idea of deboning the chicken. Took longer to cook chicken than any other item on the menu, and so by deboning it, you reduce your cooking time to half. Today, we set a world's record cooking Chick-fil-A from start to finish, 4 minutes. So it's important we can serve you a fresh product. It's not held in the heat lamp, but that was an unexpected opportunity I had.
Well, Mike, you're the owner of one of the largest independent record companies in the country. And you've got a career that spanned 50 years now this year, right? 50 years.
Well, I started when I was a freshman in college out at California State.
Yeah.
So I have a real affinity for state colleges. I think there's something very special about students at state colleges. And I think what's special is most of those students are coming to get to learn a profession or to get a job. Mm-hmm. And they're not just going to college because their parents wanted them to go. They're going because they want to go.
The good news about entrepreneur thinking is it's really nothing more than just a roadmap. And if you study it, you can learn it. And the more you learn, the bigger your dreams and vision will become, the more success and fun you'll have, and the more money you're gonna make. Entrepreneurs, they're optimists. They develop habits and attitudes that are optimistic. They're forward thinkers. They rarely complain. They tend to hang out with other people who are optimistic thinkers. Can a negative thinking person or a pessimist be a successful entrepreneur? I'm often asked that question. The answer is no. I've never met a successful entrepreneur that's a pessimist.
My name is EJ Carrion, like carry on luggage, like carry on my wayward son, and I'm your moderator for the Extreme Entrepreneurship Tour. My goal for you today is that whatever you want to do in life is that you jump, because most people in life are like my best friend, and they live in fear, and they allow fear to control what they do for the rest of their life. They never end up jumping at what they really want to do. When it comes to actually doing it, they sit back. And I know there's a lot of things we want to do, maybe start our own business, travel the world, or whatever it is you want to do. But when it comes to doing it, my goal for you as your moderator is that you jump, like me and my other friends who took control of something we want to do, and we jump. I don't want you to live in regret like my best friend who still to this day texts me on the phone and say, man, we got to go back.
And I think people basically handle fears in two different ways. I think the first group of people, they handle fear by letting it cripple them. They let it slow down their progress, and they tend to play it safe. So they're afraid that they're not going to be able to pay their bills. So instead of kind of going after that big dream that they have that's been sitting kind of in the back closet that they haven't really made any progress on, they go out and they get a safe job and they get a safe paycheck that, you know, they get every 2 weeks, and they get comfortable and they settle. And I think that those people rarely reach their full potential because of fear. Because of that fear, they're afraid. And I want to talk about Walmart really quickly, because Walmart is kind of the safest, it's a really safe bet to go to work for Walmart. You know, it's pretty easy, pretty safe. Walmart announced earlier this year that they are closing 200 stores and that they're going to be laying off 10,000 U.S. workers, including management. So even some people that were playing it pretty safe, they're not 100% safe. So why not go for that big dream? Why not try to go after your big goal? Because even people that are not doing that possibly, they're still in the same boat as you. So just go after those dreams. That's what I'm trying to tell you guys. That's what I'm trying to get across to you. Go for it. And I hope you have dreams that are huge.